Okay, and what about what type of cancer? Because breast cancer is not only one type. There's a few different things that we need to talk about.
Yeah.
So maybe we can talk about which type of cancer is severe and which type of cancer that can be treated, or maybe is there cancers that is not that serious as well?
No, cancer is cancer.
Okay.
The essence of our cancer is about the stage that you present yourself in. So when we say in terms of staging, we say about almost 40% or 42% at stage 3 and stage 4.
Yeah.
And in this country, 11% stage at stage 4. It means the cancer, it doesn't matter the pathological arena,
mm-hmm.
it's about the staging.
Okay.
So when they come in at stage 4, survival rate is reduced to about 30%, 20%, 5 years. Stage 3 probably will do about 60%, 5 years. What we are trying to see is, does a pathology correlate with the staging? The answer is yes. Most women, almost 70%, come in because infiltrating ductal carcinoma. The cancer that starts from within the milk ducts.
Okay.
Almost 70%.
So that's called ductal carcinoma.
Ductal carcinoma,
okay.
Yes. Then we have got another 10% that come from lobule. So if we imagine the breast to be just like a tree,
mm-hmm.
the trunk of the tree is a duct.
Okay.
The leaves are the lobules.
Okay.
And only 10% of cancer comes from the lobules. Unfortunately, the lobular carcinoma is very difficult to detect on mammogram. So you may have a breast which is full of cancer, but because it's coming in the leaves, we can't see the cancer, because the only way to detect cancer is either by a lump, which is imaginable. You can see a lump, yes, but you cannot define the lump. Whereas ductal carcinoma, you can see the trunk of the tree. You've got some calcium deposits inside that, and 70% you can make a diagnosis just by looking at a good mammogram. Then comes, we've got so-called 1%, 1%, 1% of the so-called the infrequent cancers, because one of them basically inflammatory breast cancer, which looks like infection, but truly very nasty cancer. That is rare. Across the board, the commonest is the infiltrating ductal carcinoma, which can be detected by a good mammogram. Of course, an ultrasound will help to define the lump.
Define, because it's quite interesting, you say a good mammogram.
Yes.
What do you mean by that?
We have got, in the past as many years, we were using the analog. Analog basically is a so-called generic version. And now we have got the digital format.
Mm-hmm.
Now, with the digital format, of course, not many hospitals will have that because it's an expensive machine. For screening purpose, you can use an analog machine just to look out at the tissue definition, but for accuracy and more detail
mm-hmm.
you need to have the digital. So digital mammogram is just like your computer. You can shade it off, you can shade it off, you can brighten up, you can, so you can look at the grayscale and you can find even small tumors hidden within tissue. So for screening, the analog is fine,
mm-hmm.
but for diagnostic, digital. Now, we try and encourage young women, because we see a lot of breast cancer from the age of 40 to 49, young women, and the breast tissue is very dense. We advise them to do a digital mammogram, because even though the tissue is dense, but the technology has not been able to provide where we can remove the density and still look inside the breast looking for the lump. So young women with dense breast, advisable to have a digital mammogram.
Okay.
This is technology.
And talking about treatments, how does the treatment vary from, let's say you said stage 1 to stage 4?
Huge. Nowadays, stage 1 cancer can be as small as 5 millimeter. It can be 10 millimeter, mm, and it can be even up to 20 mm stage 1, where the nodes are negative. That means the nodes are the one, the filter system that is in the armpit. So stage 1 basically is limited to cancer still within the breast, less than 20 mm, not involving the lymph nodes.
Okay.
But the moment lymph nodes get involved, or the cancer is beyond 20 mm, it becomes stage 2.
Okay.
And that is into stage 2A or 2B, whether the nodes are involved or not involved. And of course, stage 3, when the cancer is more than 50
mm,
nodes most likely to be involved. And stage 4, where the cancer is already spread across all, either the lungs, liver, bones, and even the brain.
Wow.
Stage 1 can be treated easily with just simple surgery. Of course, we advocate a bit of radiation be done so that the chest wall is sterilized, and sometimes no chemotherapy. But if you have a young lady at the age of 35 with breast cancer, I mean stage 1, it would be better for her to have chemotherapy.
Okay.
Right? Because we're still chasing after an aggressive disease for a young woman.
Mm.
The issue arises, there are also women who do not want to have chemotherapy because they are yet to have to go through pregnancy. They say, look, if you do chemotherapy, my ovary might shut down. So can you prevent that? I don't want my hair to lose, basically.
Because that is also quite another issue.
Yes.
Where people are actually wondering, if I have breast cancer and I go for treatment, will it affect my fertility?
Absolutely. In all cases where we have go through chemotherapy and or some kind of hormone therapy, fertility will be affected to a degree or to even a bigger degree. So the issue arises from chemotherapy causing the ovary to shut down. If you're young, ovary may not shut down because ovary is still healthy. So you may get your periods back. Your fertility may improve, but all said and done, as you go through breast cancer, we don't advise you to get pregnant at least for the first 2 to 5 years after, as you go through the treatment. But on the other hand, we have got today technology for stage 1 and stage 2. If your cancer is hormone sensitive, almost 70% of cancers are related to the hormones that you have within you. That means your estrogen and your progesterone. And they are the one causing the breast cancer. So question arises is, what makes this hormone become your enemy when it's supposed to be your friend? It's supposed to make your bone grow, your body grow, your hair grow, your beauty. It's got to do with estrogen. And you get into menopause, when estrogen dries up, your skin dries up, your beauty goes down, your collagen level goes down. So, there are now technology where we can assess and see whether if you are hormone sensitive, we can do new elements of tests where we can see whether you really need chemotherapy or you don't. And that's called Oncotype DX, which is an American. Otherwise, for those from Belgium, it's called MammaPrint. Mama means breast. Print is a DNA technology. So you can print your DNA technology of your own cancer and see whether you have cancer, yes. Is it good cancer or is it bad cancer? Bad cancer, you've got no choice, chemotherapy. If you have good cancer, you have choice of not taking chemotherapy because the results dictate that if your cancer is good, your hormone tablet or anti-hormone tablet is enough. It's enough. But not for stage 3, but not stage 4.
Okay. So maybe we can go on to a very general view, your advice for people who should start doing mammograms and how often they should do it and things like that.
In perspective, mammogram is about looking into the breast. But because it involves a small dose of radiation, so the advocacy we started almost like 40 years ago is to do mammogram every 3 years. And we do that from the age of 40 because that's when we see women, or rather the graph for cancer starts to grow vertically up. And in this country, 40 to 49, we have almost like 30% of women with breast cancer. 30%. And if you reverse that and see what the American figures show, it's only 21%. So we have got a huge difference between 21% and 33%. It goes to show, is it that suddenly we as Asians have developed too fast? We are making a dietary change. Even though it's cultural, we are making a huge change. Our nasi lemak now has become nasi lemak rendang, right? With a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
Calorie value has gone up. So we talk about refined carbs rather than the fat, which was a prime blame. So the essence is things have changed. But the element here is, if that is the case, we want to say at 40, we define the mammogram for the age of 40. Even though some countries say 43, 46 and 49, then every year after the age of 50. But my advice, after having been through the industry for so many years and having young women with breast cancer, we advise women to do every 2 years.
Every 2 years?
Every 2 years from the age of 40.
From the age of 40?
40, yes. Okay. After the age of 50, if you have been screened through, you have no lumps, no suspicion, you can still do every 2 years, whereas Americans will record as every year. So I think from the Asian context, we should follow the Asian formula. What is common in all the 14 Asian countries? and there was a conference to discuss on this issue, that most breast cancer, almost 52%, are under the age of 49.
Wow.
It's only for the younger women at the age of 20, because we're already seeing breast cancer at age 20, 30s, and a lot of young women, even at the age of 33, 34, with breast cancer, we encourage them to do ultrasound every 3 years or 2 years, if you've got a lump, every year. And if you have a family history, you must do ultrasound every year and you must do mammogram every year, even though you're below the age of 40. Because we are trying to see if there are any changes in the breast tissue taking place consequent to your genetic essence, whether you can see some calcification or otherwise. Of course, after the age of 50, what we have noticed in this Malaysian context, a lot of our women after the age of 50 don't come for mammogram. So my advocacy through the foundation and of course to the media is for the younger women who are attending our forum and all our seminars to talk to their mothers, their aunties, their grandmothers who are at home, not only in KL but beyond KL. Go to the center of hospitals, whether general hospitals or private, whatever it is, get a mammogram done, understand your baseline. If you're fine, you're fine. The idea is we are now seeing women at the age of 80s, 86 with breast cancer when the cancer is really stage 4. It's because we have neglected to take them for mammogram at an earlier stage.
All right.